police approach with lights and sirens, guns drawn, and take a homeowner down.
The problem is, in Mission last night, they were at the wrong house. The confusion was over Beverly Lane and Beverly Avenue. KMBC 9's Peggy Breit live where the two streets split. Peggy?
Well, that's right, Larry. We are right in the heart of Mission, and going one way at this fork in the road would have brought police to the home where they were needed, a serious threatening call. Going the other way brought them to the home of Anthony Rigoliso, his wife and toddler son.
It's a scary experience. And
scary, Anthony says, was only the beginning. It started around 10:30 last night with first a knock, then a pounding on the door. Anthony didn't understand.
When I got to the door, you know, I saw a flashlight and I heard a bunch of yells telling me to get out of the house. It took me a minute to register what was happening. I was pretty scared. I really didn't know who it was. I didn't know if it was the police.
But when Anthony did realize who it was, he came outside.
Get down on my knees and, you know, my face, and that's when I got handcuffed.
What Anthony didn't know is that Mission police were answering a serious call with the possibility that a 14-year-old girl was in danger.
The report came in that the resident was impaired, possibly by drugs, had a handgun in his possession.
Chief John Simmons says the tactics his officers used were appropriate, but the Johnson County Sheriff dispatcher had mixed up Lane with Avenue. When the officers realized what happened, they left and went to the right house. But Anthony says that left him, his family, and his neighbors stewing and worrying all night.
Just afterwards, we were kind of left hanging in the air, and you know, that was the one issue that I really had, and the one that's really affected us the most.
Anthony and the chief had now talked, and the Rigolizos feel better tonight, especially because of the chief's admission of a mistake and this promise.
When we make mistakes, we will correct them, and we can and will do better.
Anthony says tonight he's calmer. He's just glad no one was hurt. The chief says fortunately most Mission residents are law-abiding like the Rigolizos and never have to encounter the tougher side of the Mission police. We're live in Mission. Back to you in the studio, Larry.
Peggy, thank you very much. Mission investigators are still working on the original case, so few details are available tonight, but they do tell us the 14-year-old believed to be in danger is fine tonight.